Hello students, how are you? Last video I posted with the title of concept of 50%. This video is in continuation of the last video only. I have received a few calls. They have all students have asked that can we use this method for the day trading also? Yes, why not? We can use this method for the day trading or the swing trading. What is the difference between day trading and the swing trading is, day trading is where we close our trade within a day only. And the swing trading is we can carry over our trade for say next trade for 3-4 days until unless the move which has been started is not completed. Say it may last for 1 day, 3 day, 5 day, 7 day, then till the move is being completed, we say this is a swing, complete swing from up to down and down to up, from low to high, high to low. Okay, now say if we have to look for the day trading, first we will change our chart time frame from a day to 15 minutes. We'll take the high low of 15 minutes. Then we will be able to calculate in a good manner. All right. So we will be doing that exercise. Okay. Let's calculate the high and low of this 15 minutes chart. Okay. Here we have high and low. We have to look for, okay, highest high and the lowest low. We will look for it. Highest high is 11,849.50. Say 11,850. I'll take this high, I will take as 11,850. And the low what we have is, low we have is, this is the low, 11,564.80. So 11,564.80, let's take 565 by rounding it. So the difference between the two is 285. What I will do, I will take half of it, and half is 172.50. What I will do, I will add that into low or subtract from the high. If I add 142.50 to 11,565, I will get 11,707. 11,707. Okay, this is the one. This is the midpoint. And look, market closed today to that point only. How many times it has tested this support level? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five times it has tested this level and bounced from that level. And earlier it was working as a resistance level. Market was approaching this level and falling from this point. So this, on even day trading, if it has gone above this point, it has rallied, and from if it dropped from this point, it has taken this point downside, then it has dropped. Now let's take out the target also. Target what would be? We will take half of 142.50, that is 71.25. Now we will add this 71.25 to midpoint. Midpoint is what? Midpoint is 11,707.50. If we add 71.25 to it, we get 11,778.75. So this is our resistance. 11,779. This is the resistance. Market dropped from this level only. And whenever it has, next time, whenever it try to attempt to this point, dropped from there. Tried to attempt this point, dropped from there. So this is working as a very good resistance. So we can get a good sport and resistance. Now let's take out the sport level also. Sport level from the midpoint, what we will do? We will subtract 7125. And what we will get? 11,636.25. 11,636. 11,336. This point. And look. From there, it dropped to this level only and bounced. So, the midpoint and midpoint of midpoints. Midpoint and the midpoints of midpoint are working as a good support and resistance. We can take clue for trading in day and the swing chart. Now let's see what were the high and low earlier. Let's find out the high lows, earlier high lows of the chart. Let's find out high and lows. Okay, so this is a low. This is a low. This is 11,312. And what was the high? High made after that, this is the high which was being made earlier. This was 11,761. 11,761. Rest, the formula will work for us. So midpoint we got is 11,536. Let's draw this line. 11,536. This is the point. Oh my God. Oh my God. This is the midpoint. And market tried to touch this somewhere near to this. Once, twice, thrice, teen bar. Market tried to come closer to our midpoint. And from there only it bounced back. So the important level for us is 11,446 or 11,536. Whenever the market will breach this point, 11,537, it means then there will be a new journey which will be southward. Until and unless it is above that, we are in a bullish mode. And from where, if it breach 707 and then can come down to 537. So this is how we can take clue from the midpoint. I don't know. I have, I'm surprised why I have not tested again earlier. It was working as a very good resistance over here. And once this midpoint was taken, one, two, the price has taken, breached this level and attempted to this point once, twice and thrice and bounced back from this level only. If it would have breached below 11,536, then we would have been in a bear market till the time we are in a bull market. Where it is finding the resistance right now? It is finding a resistance near 11,780. Right, again and again it is trying to, and now market is in a narrow range of 11,780 and 11,707. Oh my God, So